The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of Access for Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting groups. If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
Good to be in the house of the Lord today, amen.
Amen.
All right. It's a beautiful day outside. Mm-hmm. So we're going to thank God for all that he has done.
Amen.
And all he's going to do. At this time, I'd like to open up in prayer so if we can bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. Thank you for blessing us with another day, Lord, that we can praise your name, Father. Lord God, we pray for all the people who are sick, couldn't make it in to hear your word today. We ask that you bless them, camp your loving angels around them and keep them safe, Lord God. We pray for the people who don't have a place to go, Father. We just ask that you bless them also, Lord. Lord God, we pray for this service. We want it to go the way you want it to go, Lord. Let someone leave here blessed. Let someone leave here different than when they came in, Father.
Yes, God.
Just touch their heart, touch their mind, Father. Let your blood flow. We thank you. We praise you for everything, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Amen. Do the...
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Just as a reminder, next Sunday, that's the first Sunday in September, that's Labor Day service. All the churches in the 46808 community are coming together in one accord. We will be having a joint service, a unity service. It will be off of St. Mary's Avenue at the little, everybody knows, used to be a police station or whatever there, but now it's a park. Right before you get to the Chase Bank. So that's where we will have our service. Everybody has been asked to bring something, so our church is bringing the macaroni and cheese, and I'm preparing that, and then other churches are bringing different things. We're gonna have a beautiful, beautiful service. It will be recorded, and we just thank God for the opportunity that he is giving us to come together on one accord with other churches. It's not about your denomination. It's about your relationship with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And that's what we're going to do. We're going to be able to praise the Lord in one accord. And we thank God for that. That'll be next week. Lay will start.
Come on, get. I got a devotional here. And the devotional is called Stepping Out on Faith. Stepping Out on Faith. One of the most fearful things in life is failure. Failure can lead to doubt. Doubt can lead to procrastination. And procrastination can lead to regret. I don't know about you, but if the Lord is clearly calling me to step out in faith, I need to start placing one foot in front of the other. I don't want to be on my deathbed and look back having regret and missed opportunities. Amen.
Amen.
Today, we will be looking at an opportunity that I will be forever grateful to have. The opportunity to walk alongside my Savior in a place that no one else would ever imagine. In Matthew 14, 22 through 29, we see a picture of the disciples in a boat on the Sea of Galilee. Jesus then shows himself to the disciples in a way that truly tests their faith. In verse 26, Matthew recalls the disciples as terrified to the point where they cried out in fear. If you've read this passage before, it seems almost comical of the disciples to be unable to recognize their teacher. How many times in our lives has the Lord shown up and we've been unable to recognize him? How many times has Jesus given you an opportunity, but you were unable to see it because you were too busy with life? Man, that happens a lot. In our text, Jesus spoke to the terrified disciples. Take courage. It is I. Don't be afraid. We see the very first thing Jesus spoke to the disciples was take courage. Jesus literally told them, don't be afraid. I pray that we truly take this to heart. This is where stepping out on faith begins. While the disciples were in their boat, being tossed by the waves and wind, one disciple, Peter, took courage and replied to Jesus. Peter said, Lord, if it is you, tell me to come to you on the water. In one single word, Jesus replied, come. Peter then got down out of the boat and walked on the water toward Jesus. This is such a beautiful picture of Peter's obedience and acknowledgement to Jesus. If you know this passage, you know what happens next. But for one second, we focus on the trust that Peter had in Jesus. He was willing to do something that was deemed impossible. Peter accomplished the impossible by focusing on and trusting in Jesus. Think about the impossible things in your life right now. If you are able to focus fully on Jesus and step out of the boat like Peter, do you believe that with Jesus you can accomplish the impossible? I do. You can. If Jesus can walk with Peter on water, he can walk with you in your darkest days.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
It all begins with a single step. Before you can fall, you have to take a step of faith. Today's focus, it says, today, I challenge you, all of us, to become more aware of Jesus' presence in your everyday life. Our God is always chasing after us. He is always watching over us. Trust in him and start to take that step of faith today. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I know sometimes I get wrapped up in life and I start doing things without involving Jesus first. And when I do that, a lot of times things don't work out the way I want them to. And so that is something I really need to do, is start putting God first before everything, every decision, before everything. Just put him first and everything will work out. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Well, I like to start praising the Lord in song. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
If I can get the praise and worship team to come up here.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. If we can stand while we praise our Lord in song. This is a beautiful day outside.
Amen.
Gorgeous day. Lovely day. Every day is a good day to praise the Lord. Amen. This song is Let It Rise. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us.
Yes.
Amen. Okay, Wes.
Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the songs of the Lord rise among us. Let the joy of our King rise among us.
That was the one. Glory, all the reason, King.
praise is what I do.
Praise is what I do. When I want to be close to you,
amen.
Amen.
Amen. At this time, we would like to call our pastor up.
so that she can give us the word the Lord has given her to give to us. Amen. Let's give her a round of applause.
Hallelujah. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Father. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise Him. Yes, God. Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him. Jesus, blessed Savior, He's worthy to be praised. Let's praise Him. Hallelujah. Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him. Jesus, blessed Savior, He's worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun up to the going down of the same, He's worthy. Blessed Savior, Dancing in the rain. Hallelujah. I was looking at at this little segue that somebody had wrote it. They don't know who wrote it, but it says, life is not about waiting for the storm to pass. It's about dancing in the rain. Hallelujah. We don't have to wait until the storm passes. We can shout now. We don't have to wait till the situation clear up. We can shout now because we know that we got our Lord and Savior by our side. Hallelujah. Life is not about waiting for the storm to pass. It's about dancing in the rain. Hallelujah. When you know that you are walking in the will of God and you have stepped into your promised land. Now let me share with you what the promised land is. A lot of people think that your promised land begins when you get your vision and you get your dreams and you get your desires. No, your promised land starts when you accept the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ as your Savior. When you accept the fact that you can't do anything by yourself, you have to trust God to do it for you. When you accept the fact that you need the Holy Spirit to lead and guide and direct you every day of your life, that's when your promised land starts. That's when you begin to walk in the promises of God. That's when you begin to see that God is with you in season and out. I don't care what storm comes up. When you're a child of God, you can dance in the rain. You can dance like David danced in the midst of your situation. Hallelujah. When you know that you're walking with the Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We all know that life can throw you some negative blows because the enemy wants to take you back to your Egypt. The enemy wants to take you back to where you was before you knew who Jesus Christ was. The enemy wants you to go back into your old sins. The enemy wants you to look back. Hallelujah. And don't you know what look back can cause? Looking back over your situation is telling God that you don't trust him to take you to your future. Looking back, hallelujah, just like our Lot's wife can turn you into a pillow of salt. That's what looking back can do. There's nothing wrong with you look back to go forward. And I'm not talking about look back to stay back. I'm talking about to use your past testimony to help somebody else to go forward. Not look back to stay back. Because there's nothing back there that God wants you to keep. All he wants you to do is use your life experiences to help somebody else to know. Just like he brought you out, he can bring them out. All you got to do is trust and believe in our Father. Hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah. The enemy will destroy your mind if you allow him. Just when you think things have gotten really bad, they get worse. That's how the enemy wants you to look at things. When situations in your life get bad, he wants you to say, uh-oh, hallelujah, you're not going to be able to make it. You need to go back to your old ways of doing things, your old ways of getting out of trouble, your old ways of where you thought. That's what the enemy wants you to do. But God wants you to have faith. He wants you to trust and believe in him. Hallelujah. The enemy, hallelujah, will bring storms in your life. Storms that can detract and distract you. Hallelujah. And you allow one thing to happen in the next. But one thing I've learned, hallelujah, that God is sovereign. Now he's a provisional God. Hallelujah. Nothing that happens outside of the parameter of his will can happen to you. Everything, all things work together for the good. Some of the bad things happen to you because of your own deceitfulness, your own miswill in God, your own way of doing things. Some things happen to you because God is trying to help you to grow, to help you to grow up. Hallelujah. You think about a baby. Hallelujah. When they're crawling. Hallelujah. Then they start climbing up on things. And the parents will tell them, don't do that. But you know, baby, you too young, don't get up on that. But they'll continue to do it. But after a while, when they fall enough times, and they won't get back up on that thing because they remember the pain when they fail. When they try to start walking, hallelujah, baby will be walking, and he might fall down, and she might fall down. But you know what? They'll fall so many times, and you get to the point when they get up, they'll begin to steady their legs. They won't go and try to walk too fast. They'll steady their legs to make sure that they're standing up all right, and I can see the parents trust God. We got to believe in his word. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. You got to learn how to dance in the rain. How many, hallelujah, have been in a rain situation where it's really raining outside? And you're trying to get to the other side. You're trying to get to where God wants you to go. But it seems like every time you try, things get worse and worse and worse. And I know you can hear the enemy, because I know he did it to me. And he's no respecter of person, just like God isn't. He don't care. When you're not his child, he's going to try to destroy you and take you back to where you think he wants you to be. But in actuality, when the devil starts messing with your mind and you are a child of God, you can never go back to where you used to be. You'll just be in limbo. You either got to follow God or you're going to be out there by yourself being tormented. But God wants you to know, when the devil comes in and start messing with your mind, when he begins to make you look through your natural eyes instead of your spiritual eyes, where you can see what God is doing, instead of you using your wisdom that God has given you through his word, you'll begin to use your own thought process. And how many know that we can't think of nothing? And we're not ready now. We're not worthy to fix situations on our own. God has to do it. Because when we think of trying to do things, we want it done quick, fast, and in a hurry. We become microwave kids. We want to do it the way we want to do it. Like everything have it our way. We can't have everything our way. We got to do it God's way. And sometimes that takes patience. That takes wisdom. That takes a Lord walking with God and listening to him. Having that spiritual ear where you can hear what the Spirit is telling you. Yet sometimes you just got to be still and hear what God is saying. He will bring you through if you hear him. He will bring you through. I don't care how bad the rain is. I don't care how bad the situation is. You might be standing in the rain right now. But let me tell you something. The wind storms may be coming in your life. But if you just be still, the Lord is going to tell your storm, peace. Hallelujah. All we got to do is be still and walk through with the Father. And see, one thing about it, when you are in a storm and you allow the Lord to bring you out of that storm, you will never have to go through that storm again. You will use it as a testimony to help somebody else to go through. But when we use our own minds, and we're in the midst of a storm, and we tend to think we're coming out of that storm, guess what? You got to go through that storm again. And the reason being is because we didn't do it God's way. We tried to come out of it on our own mind. And we can't do nothing without him. So the storm that we think we came out of, all we're doing is putting ourselves in a situation to go back through that lesson one more time. Because we're not doing it the way God, we haven't learned it. Learn what God is saying. We're doing it our way and not God's way. And I don't know about you, but I don't want to go through storms over and over and over and over again in order to do it God's way. I want to do it right the first time. I want to allow the Lord to take me through the first time. So I won't have to go back through that same situation over and over again. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You might say, I'm in the midst of the storm. What do I have to dance about? You can dance about the fact that you're a child of God. And he knows what you're dealing with and what you're going through. And he will bring you through if you allow him to do so. Hallelujah. Dancing in your trials tells God that you trust him. And that you trust gives the devil a black eye. When you trust God, the devil gives you, be punching him in the eye. Wherever you give God all your faith and all your trust, the devil has to give back. Because lack of faith and faith can't stay in the same room. It can't stay in the same place. If you got faith in God, then that lack of faith has to get out of the way. If you got trust in God, then that lack of trust got to get out of the way. Hallelujah, because they can't stay in the same place together. Hallelujah. And I'm going to give you some scriptures that I want you to look at. And Psalms 119, 71. You got a pen, write these down because I'm going to try to go through quickly. Psalms 119, 71. It is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I may learn your statutes. Now you might say, affliction being good for me? Yes, it is. Because it causes you, some afflictions cause you to get down on your knees and try and pray to God and trust his word and look to him to bring you out. That's good for you to learn God's statutes, to learn what his word says. It's good. Sometimes afflictions come upon you for your betterment in the name of Jesus. For his anger is but for a moment. His favor is for life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Psalms 30, verse 5. Hallelujah. Weeping, we may cry for a moment, and it may be just for a small period of time, but our joy is for a lifetime. Hallelujah. This joy that I have, the world didn't get it, and the world can't take it away. If you trust in the Lord, he will give you joy. He will give you peace. He will give you understanding. He will give you wisdom. He will give you knowledge. He will give you all that you need as you're going through that valley of weeping. As you're going through, he will let you know you're not alone. I have you. I'm walking with you. Sometimes I'm picking you up and carrying you because you can't go by yourself. But I'm with you. Even when you're weeping, I'm with you. And I understand just what he's talking about. I've wept for my son. I've wept for my mother. And if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, I know I never would have made it. But God was on my side. Hallelujah. But the more they afflicted them, the more they multiplied and grew. And they were in dread of the children of Israel. And that's in Exodus 1:12. And we know the story. That's when the Israelites in Egypt, and they had them in bondage. Pharaoh had them in bondage. And the more the affliction they put on them, the more they grew. In other words, the larger they got, the harder, the more people came into their lives. The more they were afflicted, the more they grew in Christ Jesus. Sometimes the more we are afflicted by the things that happen in this world, the better, the more we grow. We grow spiritually. We grow in a way that we understand that God is with us. We understand, hallelujah, that he has all the host of angels right here for us. We especially understand that the Holy Spirit is here. And if we listen to his voice, he'll take us through every affliction. And in Isaiah 54:17, no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. Amen. And every tongue that rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. Amen. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. And their righteousness is from me, says the Lord. God has given us power and authority through the name, through the blood of Jesus Christ. When situations come upon us, when people talk about us, don't get down to their level. Don't be like they are. So oftentimes when we feel that we're being mistreated or misused or misunderstood, and that people talking about us, we'll begin to talk about them the same way they're talking about us. Why, as a child of God, are you allowing the things that the devil has put in somebody else's life to bring you down from where you're supposed to be? You are a child of God. And you got the power of the Holy Spirit. You got the same power as we see that rose Jesus from the dead lives in you. Amen. And you don't have to go and stoop down to somebody else's level just thinking that you're getting back at them. The way you get back at them is by standing tall and firm on God's word. And if they're talking about you, as the Bible said, turn the other cheek, allow spite of what you're saying, in spite of what you're doing, I love you with the love of Jesus Christ. And that will shake their mouths. And sometimes, and when people are talking, shut up and let the Lord handle it. Be quiet and let the Lord fight your battle. You don't always have to open your mouth and have a word to say back, because all that does is cause you to be in a negative situation just like they are. Be still. Be quiet and let God handle the situation. Yeah. Move on and let God handle the situation. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. It didn't say it wouldn't form, but it did say it would not prosper. Amen. And God knows that it will not prosper, because he has given you the power to overcome any situation. Amen. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. And in Romans 5:3-5, and not only that, but we also glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation produces perseverance, and perseverance character, and character hope. Now hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit, who has given to us, hallelujah, and everything, hallelujah, God has given it to us, hallelujah. Oh God, he says, tribulation produces perseverance. Instead of backing down and cowering down and being a woe is me and having pity parties that don't nobody come to but yourself, hallelujah, persevere through the tribulation. And that will give you character. And when you receive the character that God will have you be, have, that will bring on a hope. And hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts by the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit was given to us by the Father. And he's always here to help us through any tribulation. Amen. And finally, in 1 Thessalonians 5:18, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Give thanks. I don't care what it looked like. Give thanks. I don't care what's the situation. Give thanks. When the Spirit of the Lord, when you give thanks, the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you, and you'll be able to dance like David danced. You'll be able to dance in the midst of any situation. You'll be able to dance and sing hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He's given me the power. He's given me the strength to make it through every day of my life. And I'm going to dance hallelujah like David danced. In Jesus' name, to God be the glory. God bless you. I'll turn this over to our praise and worship. In Jesus' name. Prior to that, I'm sorry, I forgot. We're going to have our whole communion. Today is communion. So if I could have Lay and Dale, if you could come up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is a time for us to remember, hallelujah, what God has done. Hallelujah. Oh, we thank you, Father God. If you can take the elements and then we'll pray over them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Yes, God. The Lord himself ordained this holy sacrament. He commanded his disciples to partake of the bread and wine emblems of his broken body and shed blood. This is his table. The feast is for his disciples. Let all those who have with true repentance forsaken their sins and have believed in Christ until salvation draw near and take these emblems and lay by faith partake of the life of Jesus Christ to your soul's comfort and joy. Let us remember that it is the memorial of the death and the passing of our Lord. Also a token of his coming again. Let us not forget that are one at one table with the Lord. Hallelujah. Let us close our eyes and our minds, and we begin to ask God to forgive us of any sins that we may have committed or omitted, so that we will be in the right frame of mind when we receive, hallelujah, this precious gift. Let's take a moment. Thank you, Jesus. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who out of your tender mercies gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, hear us. We most humbly beseech you, grant that as we receive these your creatures of bread and wine, according to the holy institution of your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ, in remembrance of his passion and death, we may be made partakers of the benefits of his atoning sacrifice. You may pass the animals. You may go. Thank you, Jesus. The blood of Jesus Christ, which was taken for you. The blood of Jesus Christ. What you can keep it up here. The blood of Jesus Christ. The bread, hallelujah, which is his body, which was taken for you. The blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. The blood of Jesus Christ. The bread of his life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Thank you, God. The blood of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, the blood of Jesus.
Hallelujah, the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The blood is the bread of his body. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lane. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. They always got to get the bread. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. We are reminded that in the same night that our Lord was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." You may take the bread and eat it. Thank you, Jesus. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, which was poured out for you. Do this whenever you drink it, in remembrance of me."
We may drink.
May we come before you in true humility and faith as we partake of these, the holy sacraments, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood.
Article 11 discusses our beliefs about the church, the community of people that declare Jesus as Lord. It includes people in local groups, as well as all people in the world that declare Jesus as Lord. The church organizes itself differently, depending on culture. And because of this, it changes over time and is different in different places. However, what God calls the church to do remains the same. God calls those who are spiritually alive to do things together, including honoring God by preaching His Word, doing special ceremonies called sacraments, helping meet the needs of others, which is called ministry, in His name, obeying Jesus as Lord, living in a way that honors God, and holding each other accountable to these things. The church's mission on earth is to be part of Jesus' work to help people. It accomplishes this mission by making disciples through evangelism, education, showing compassion, working for justice, and being living proof of the kingdom of God. The church also puts people into certain positions to support the work that God has asked that person to do. Think of positions like pastor, missionary, or superintendent. Article 12 states what we believe about Christian baptism. The sacrament of baptism is commanded by God and is a sign of a person accepting the benefits of atonement and becoming part of the body of Christ, which is the Christian church. Baptism is a means of grace that publicly shows a person's faith in Jesus Christ as Savior. It is to be done with believers who fully intend to live a life of holiness and righteousness. Young children and the morally innocent may be baptized at the request of their parents or guardians, with the church promising to provide Christian training to them. Baptism can be done through sprinkling, immersion, or pouring. Article 13 discusses our beliefs about the Lord's Supper. The Lord's Supper, which is also called communion, was started by Jesus and is a sacrament that speaks to His life, sufferings, sacrificial death, resurrection, and the hope of His coming again. The Lord's Supper is a means of grace in which Christ is there by the Holy Spirit. All who have faith in Christ are invited to participate and be renewed in life, salvation, and in unity as the church. All who participate are to do so with great appreciation of its important meaning, and by this sacrament show the Lord's death until He comes again. Those who have faith in Christ and love for the saints are invited by Christ to participate as often as possible. Article 14 states our belief about biblical healing. Because we believe that our God is all-powerful, we believe that He can heal any illness. In Article 14, the Nazarene faith urges its people to seek prayer for their illnesses. However, we also believe that God heals through medical science. Article 15 states our belief that Jesus will come again, and that all believers who have passed away shall rise up, and together with those believers still living, will meet Jesus in the sky, and then be with him forever. The last article is Article 16, which discusses our beliefs about resurrection, judgment, and destiny. We believe the dead will be raised to life by God to be judged for what they did when they were alive. Those who are still alive will also be judged. We believe that glorious and everlasting life will be given to those who believed in and obediently followed Jesus, and that those who did not shall suffer forever in hell. These videos aim to point out the key parts of our beliefs in a simple, easy-to-understand form. For a deeper understanding of our faith, reference the manual or contact an ordained minister in the Church of the Nazarene.
My name is Pastor Sandra White, and I am the founder of West Main Women on the Move. MOVE stands for Motivated, Organized, Victorious, and Empowered. And this is what we're trying to do for the women of our community.
Hi, my name is Mary Geiger, and I'm the president of Women on the Move. And we are going to be having monthly lunches to offer workshops and seminars will be provided. And then we'll be doing this annually, this convention that we're getting ready to do, to empower women so they know that they have a voice too.
What we're looking for right now are partners. We want to partner with people in the community. You may have a fantastic testimony, or you may be a professional that has resources that the women that attend our monthly luncheons can gain information and insight from you. We also, during our annual conference, will support other grassroots organizations with part of the benefit from the conference. And those funds will hopefully be used by those grassroots organizations to further their. Each year, we will be hosting an annual conference. And within that conference, part of the proceeds will go to benefit another grassroots organization whose mission fits into what we're doing. We're seeking persons who want to be participants, as well as those who would desire to have a partnership with us to share their testimonies or expertise in this tremendous event, as well as our monthly luncheons. There will be two videos that you will see in just a second that will share with you what we are all about. Thank you, and may God bless.
Hi, everyone. My name is Jacqueline Parrish, and I was just coming to share a little bit of my story and spread a little encouragement. I am a single mother of four children, and all of them are very, very talented, and I can see they're going to be very successful. I have been through a lot. I have been through divorce. I have been through heartache. I have been through being homeless, no car, no job. There's nothing that you have been through that I haven't been through. But the key is that you have to put God first, put your trust in God, and know that everything happens for a reason. I never gave up. I used my determination. I used my kids as my determination. And I always looked at the positive out of all negative situations. When I used them as my determination, everything fell into place. It may not have fell into place when I wanted it to, but God still kept a roof over our head, whether I had to stay with a friend or he provided me money to go to a...
Hi, my name is April Carroll. I am a pharmaceutical chemist by trade, but currently I'm a global project manager for a biotech company located right here in Atlanta, Georgia. On the side, if you can believe that, I am a director of my own volleyball club, which is a USAV AAU volleyball club that houses more than 200 kids trying to get them scholarships to play collegiately. I'm also an NCAA volleyball official. I still participate in the game as an athlete, as well as coach and try to mentor young youth. With all that going on, you can only imagine why I was asked to talk to you today a little bit about organization. I truly believe in 1 Corinthians 14:40 that everything is done decently and in order. I believe that wholeheartedly. I try to live my life by doing so. I try to align my life by making sure that I put things in priority, by making sure I speak to the Lord every day, making sure I give 110% to my job, 110% to those kids. But the only way to do that is to make sure I'm organized. Everything is written down because I want to make sure I take advantage of every opportunity that I have, every minute of the day, every second of the day, because I know I will never get that back. So I call time and energy and effort a gift from the Lord. So that's why I put so much time and energy into making sure I take advantage of every particular moment of the day. In doing so, I've come to realize that I actually have more time to make sure I also take care of myself. I love working out. I actually work out about 3 to 4 hours a day, sometimes twice a day. So if you can imagine going to work as my regular job, making sure I'm a mentor to the youth, as well as making sure I take care of family. I've been married for almost 24 years, and I call that a blessing in and of itself. So organization is really, really critical. But my one key point would be make sure you write things down. Write it down. Make it plain. That's also in the Bible. I try to live my life by the simplest things in the Bible so it can become practical and I can also give that particular advice to someone else. So in terms of organization, I love it. It keeps me sane. It keeps everything organized and it makes sure that I don't do anything. I don't duplicate my efforts, that I work smarter, not harder. So I'm glad you allowed me to have this conversation with you. And I bid you good day in organizing your life. Just the same. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much for listening to us, and we pray that you will be a part of Women on the Move, West Main Women on the Move. We give you God the glory.
Cause I can see the breaking.
I can see the breaking of day.
God is
making a way. Change is coming for me.
If I stand strong
and believe,
There's no reason to doubt.
I know he's working it out.
And it's turning around.
Hero and conquered the grave. Amen.